So Diana's down there unpacking, shopping. I've taken some of my chicken out because I'm gonna put some chicken in my soup. I'm making soup, so I'm cutting up the chicken. Us Jamaicans, we love our chicken small and chop up nice. I don't want no big pieces of chicken in my soup. You want to get a little parcel in your mouth, you know, when you're drinking the soup. You want to get a nice little parcel of chicken.
Yeah, especially.
So I'm gonna wash the chicken and take out all of this. But as I'm going to cut it up, I'm going the other piece, I haven't cleaned it out yet. Because I've already chopped it up. So when I wash it, I'm gonna take out all of this from the small pieces. But I wanted to make a video of me cutting the chicken. So at the butcher's, I bought the leg and thigh pieces, and the butcher already separated them by the joint. So this was here. This was here, like this, and these cut it in the bone joint there. So can be a bit hard if you haven't got like a big chopper to cut through the bone. That went straight through though, but in case you can't cut through the bone, you put the knife on it and you get a little heavier thing. So I've got a mallet, or it looks like a hammer, and knock the back of the knife, and there you go, through the bone. So if you want to cut straight across, put the knife across the back of the chicken and hit the back part. And there you go, through the bone. Because not everybody is strong enough to make one chop and go through the bone. So, and here you go. When you cut this, I cut down and then you turn the knife to go under, to go through the joint. And that way you don't have to cut through the bone. You've just separated those two pieces. Let's clean up the extra fat from the chicken if you want to. I don't know if everybody does that, but I do. I don't take too much off, to be honest, because it boils out anyway. Or if you're frying it, it kind of goes. But I do as much as I'm happy with. I don't want like to see too much excess of them white things. Like when you go to some restaurants and you buy fried chicken and you take the skin off, it has all of these fat underneath. I just did my nails as well. So now I can comb my hair without my hair going in underneath my nails, which is what I plan to do. I don't know if I'm gonna get around to it, or I'm gonna have to do it in the evening. This is me whenever I get too busy, like at the weekend, and I don't get to do everything. For example, ironing. Say I'm out for the weekend and I don't get to finish all the ironing. That's a Monday evening. That can be a Monday evening job. Or whenever I find time in the week, I don't always, maybe it's going to be because the beginning of my week as a teacher can be quite busy because you're preparing for the rest of the week. Beginning of the term can be quite busy because you're preparing for the rest of the month. So that's going to go in my soup. It's not a lot of soup, it's just me and Diana, and I'm gonna bring some for my grandmother. I say tomorrow. So I'm just going to wash this chicken now, clean it up. But before I do that, I'm going to put some vinegar on it. You can use malt vinegar or the clear one, whatever it's called. Malt vinegar is the brown one. So I'm just putting some vinegar on that to give it a nice wash, to cut all the slime. I don't know how people don't wash their meat because it's so slimy. When you wash it, it's not so slimy and slippery, and definitely smells fresh. Cuts the rawness from the chicken. It doesn't get rid of the chicken flavor at all, because the chicken is naturally has a natural flavor in it. So I'm going to wash that off in some cold water. You don't want to use hot water to wash your chicken because you don't want your chicken to start cooking under the tap. I did have this chicken defrosting, but I'm using this chicken straight from the butcher's because it's already defrosted. That chicken, I might still end up seasoning it because it's halfway defrosted. I could have still used it, but it would still be quite cold. So I'm just going to look if I, if them bits that I didn't wash out from the back of the chicken, from the thigh, if they've come out from those, because there's one piece I didn't clean out, one piece I just chopped it up. I should have really, but yeah, it looked like it's gone. But oh, here it is. Although I was just about to say, wanna kill fatten. But when you buy this from certain restaurants, when you buy fried chicken and you're eating the fried chicken, like something FC, it has all of this in the back. Who still eat them out? Me, when me buy my fried chicken, me nyam them. But when I cook when I cook my own chicken at home, I clean that out. But I'm telling you the honest truth, I've eaten that out of a piece of KFC before.
I've had my
pumpkin boiling, so I'm going to add this chicken to the water.
Mom, I do not like that.
Mm? You do not want?
Like how that looks.
Yeah, because it's the bits from the chicken which I'm going to wash soon. So let's get this video over my pot. Can't turn the camera. I don't see the option to turn the camera. So here it goes. Please don't drop in my pot phone. This is a new tripod stick I'm using. So I'm not going to pre-season that chicken. Don't know what anybody else does, but I don't see the point because I'm soon season the pot and it's boiling anyway. Here we go.
Ow.
That's my chicken cut up.
Sorry guys, I had to show you this.
Gonna make that boil a little bit and I'm gonna add some bits into the pot like my pimento and some natural seasoning. Nobody taught me to cook chicken soup. I might not cook it like the average Jamaican, but I know it's gonna taste like what it's supposed to because everybody has different times when they put different things in it. But let me try and see now. So I'm gonna boil the chicken and the pumpkin a little bit more. I'm going to make my, need my dumpling, need my flour. I'm going to peel my yam. Those I'm going to put in a bowl to the side. When I finish cutting them up, I'm going to add them to the pot. I'm going to add my, I'm going to season the pot. Then I'm going to add my dumplings. Yeah, and I got my chicken noodle. I got sweet potato. I like some people don't put sweet potato in soup. I remember growing up, other people said sweet potato not going in a soup. Well, I've had sweet potato in soup and trust me, it makes it nice. So I'm going to get my food, my yam. Let me knead.